God is going to show up. He's standing right by. We want to say that one more time for somebody who may be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Because joy is on the way. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Know that God is now.
My God. Hey. Ho. Halalabasa. Hey. My God. My God. Ah. Hey. Ho. My God. There is a bomb. Ah. Yes, Lord. There is above in Gilead. Oh, you hear? There is a Baal in Gilead. Hey, halalabasia, vazovo, pisiko, maskapa, pasutalalabasia, in Jesus' name. Listen, listen. You know I love it when God begins to speak to me. Women, we're going to pray. We're praying for women, the female, the young girls. Listen to this. Listen to this. This is going to be a simple prayer this morning. Then we're going to get out of the way. Okay? I want you to have this prayer in your spirit. You hear me this morning? 2 Kings chapter 4, okay? 2 Kings chapter 4 for the sake of time. Listen to this. This is what the Spirit of the Lord is asking every mother, every woman, everyone that has a womb, a woman. Listen, so he wants you to, and chapter 4, verse 1. A certain woman of the wives of the sons of the prophet cried out to Elisha, saying, okay, a certain woman that now gives you the qualification, since we don't have no name. Hey, he said a certain woman that put your name there, cried. See, she was a wife to one of the sons of the prophets. Mama Masha, I come and disturb me this morning. The devil is a liar. He was a son, one of the sons of the prophet. She was married to one of the sons of the prophet. And something had happened which had caused the prophet, the breadwinner, to die. And there was something coming on the horizon. And as a woman, she had nowhere to turn to. And so the Bible says she cried out. My God, she cried out. And this morning, every woman, I don't know what is in your cry. I don't know what you're going to say. I don't know what language. I don't know what your cry represents. But listen to me. Once you have put your name in this scripture, Sister Priscilla, Sister Doc, listen. You are now, halalabasia. You have now entered into a place. Because listen to me. What she had left was about to be taken away. And she cried out within herself, because watch this now, she had always looked to the prophet. You see, notice this, she didn't cry unto God, Sister Carol. She cried out, the Bible says, your servant, my husband, is dead. And you know that your servant feared the Lord. Okay. See, she didn't take her cry to God. She took her cry to the prophet. And she said to the prophet that my husband, watch this now, was your servant. And now he's dead. I just caught something. I'm going to tell you what I just saw. And the creditor, my God, is coming to take my two sons to be his slaves. Oh God. Okay. Sorry, I said I wasn't going to take too much of your time, but something just broke in my spirit. Okay. So, I love God. Don't you love God in 2016? I'm so grateful to God for everything that he's put me through, because these revelations, honestly, I really don't know where they're coming. I mean, I know where they're coming from, but I really don't. Listen, listen to this now. The woman is now a widow. Women, listen to me. She's single, widow, with two boys in her care. Now, I'm rather sure that when the husband was making the decisions in terms of the creditor, she didn't consult the wife. And so the prophet who was supposed to be looking after the sons of the prophet. And one of the sons of the prophet who was married, he's now dead and he didn't leave no money. Can I suggest to you that in the psyche or somewhere within the brain of the woman who was now crying out to the prophet, she was indirectly telling him, you know he was your servant. You know you never paid him. I just killed a demon right there. You know you never paid him. Because if you paid him, he would have left some money behind so that the creditor would not be coming. He was working for you, but he was borrowing money. See, we don't like to talk about this stuff in the church when it comes to the economics, the money. He was your servant, but you weren't looking after him. And so guess what? He was borrowing from the bank. He was borrowing from the bank in order for us to live a comfortable lifestyle, because everybody knew him to also be prophetic. Okay, what do you do when you are prophetic but your pockets don't line up with your prophetic gift because you're not being dealt with the way that you're supposed to be dealt with? The creditor is coming. The bank, 21st century, is coming. The money lender is coming. Now that thought, according to the word, we're supposed to be lenders and not borrowers. But here was the son of the prophet in debt to the creditor. And the creditor is looking for pay. Now listen to me. This is not one of those messages where the prophet will tell you, turn around three times and your debt is canceled. The devil is a liar. The creditor wants their money. You can spin around 10 times. They can put as much oil on you until they can fry KFC, Kentucky, Chick-fil-A. The creditor wants their money. And if you don't pay the creditor, Sister Thelma, he's going to come into your house. And he's going to take whatever they want, Sister Takaya. Gotta pay that creditor. So guess what? The prophet says to her, what do you have in your house? Every woman that is listening to me this morning, please don't ever cry again and tell me that you don't have nothing. Everything that you need is in your house. What do you have in your house? We're still going to deal with borrowing. You know, we're still going to deal with that because you're going to have to borrow some vessels. But with this dispensation or with this level of miracles and breakthrough that you're about to tap into, listen to me. Ha! My God. After you have finished, you'll be able to pay back every creditor that you own. Because it is no longer for the prophet to take the credit. It is for you to know that it is within your house. Your house. I'm not talking about your physical. I'm talking about your house. Every woman under the sound of my voice, Palalabasia, lift up your hand this morning. Lift up your hand this morning. Halalabasha Visovo Masi Vazava Presupa Ve Halalaba. Yes, Lord, I feel him. Every woman under the sound of my voice, if you're a woman, Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Don't engage in no conversation with nobody. Lift your hands. Remember the platform that you're on right now. Every woman. Halalabas. Hey! Halalabas. Ha! I feel God. Yes, Lord. In the name of Jesus.
Don't try to fight the battle yourself.
Stay in God. Hey!
God is going to show up.
Ha! Yes, Lord. Balalabasia. I want you to locate every woman. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Hey! You're going to tap into what is on the inside of you this morning. Halalabasa. On the inside of you, I stir up what you haven't paid any attention to. Okay. Hey! Halalabasa. Hey! There is a woman. You have a gift to design. Listen to me. Listen to me, I'm going to tone this down so you listen to me. Listen to what I'm about to tell you. Listen to me. There is a woman, you have a gift to design women's shoes. Women's shoes. Yes, Lord. You have a gift to design. There is a gifting on the inside of you that in 2016 you failed to tap into. And this morning, the Spirit of the Lord is going to direct you to pull out, is instructing you to pull out that gift. Hey, Balabasha, it's on the inside of you. It's inside of you. You hear me? And yes, Lord, I wish you could feel what I feel. There is a hey, okay, God, I'm feeling God. So the Lord is giving me, in there is somebody in your feet. You have the gift to design. Yes, Lord. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, we stir up the gift, the godly gift. Let it be stirred up this morning in Jesus' mighty name. Every woman, every female, receive this morning. I just feel that. A woman, design is on the inside of you. Hey, halalabasha. Yes, Lord. Let's worship you. Halalabasha. Hey. Yes, Lord. Hey! Ha! Thank you. There's a bomb. Get it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. God is real. He's real. I presented to you this morning what the Spirit has given us to do. I present that healing for every woman, every female, every young girl is covered by the blood of Jesus. Every young person. In Jesus' mighty name. Dr. Dana, sickness, healing because of the balm in Gilead has been taken over and it's got a balm. In Jesus' mighty name. Yes, Lord. Halalabasya. Yes, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name. I love the Lord. In Jesus' name. God bless you this morning, women. This is very powerful. The presence of the Lord just keeps on increasing in Jesus' name. God bless you. Hey, Sister Renee, God bless you. Now, listen, tomorrow, I'm going to go to the village somewhere. I just got a call. I need to go to the village, so I'm not going to have Wi-Fi. So tomorrow, I won't be able to do Periscope. What I'm going to do, rather, is I'm going to go on the prayer line, okay? Because I'm going to miss prayer. So wherever I find myself, I'm going to sneak out. And I'm going to come on the prayer line for 7 minutes because tomorrow we're praying for the men. Okay? So I'm not going to be on Periscope. So every single person who's listening to me, if you want to join in tomorrow on the phone line, do me a favor. Go to the website, okay? I'm in Ghana. And get, the phone number, okay? Or Sister Mary or somebody can put the number on now. So you can just have it, you know, in your phone. Tomorrow morning, 7 a.m., let's call and let's all come together and pray. I'm not going to be on Periscope in the morning because where I'm going to be, there is no, there is no phone, like, you know, the internet don't work there. I'm believing God that the phone will work, okay? But, the phone line, well, if you've got all the numbers, you know, it's different numbers for different cars. Okay, this is what I'm going to do. Can you do me a favor, everybody? If you don't have the number or you're not sure, please email prayermantle3@gmail.com. Okay? Please. If you don't have it, ain't gonna be no Wi-Fi where I'm going. We ain't got to that level yet here in Ghana. Pray for us. God ain't through with us yet. Okay? God ain't through with us yet. So just so that there's no confusion, please, everybody asking for, please do me a favor, please. Email prayermantle3@g. Okay, go to the website now, Dr. Nikisha, thank you. Prayermantle3.com. Go to the website, just click on it, go on there, you will get the number. Okay? Please, okay? Go on there tomorrow morning. Remember, there's not going to be Periscope because I'm going to be in the village. Okay? I'm believing God that the phone will work. It will work. You know, the internet don't work there. Okay? Please. Okay? Sister, I want to thank you. So 605-563-140. 7174. So the number is there. I believe it's the number. Okay? So please. Okay? Tomorrow for the men. I need to just go and support, you know, something that's happening in the village. Okay? Thank you, Prayer Mantle, for your support. It's coming together. It's coming together. Insurance money is going to be released. Make sure you bless the Lord when it comes through. Okay? In Jesus' name, it is done. Okay? So please make sure that you're on tomorrow. Okay? I love you. I'm praying for you. Okay? I'm praying for you. Okay? In Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. Have a blessed day. Goodbye. Goodbye. God bless you. Thank you for your support and your generosity, okay? The Lord leads you to do support this ministry. The scripture, where did I read from again? It was from the book of 2 Kings chapter 4. 2 Kings chapter 4. God bless you. Bye-bye. So remember tomorrow, pass it around. No Periscope in the morning because I'm going to be in the village, okay? God bless you. Bye-bye.